Welcome to the lecture on bowing, buckling and twisting in welds. So, we are talking about the distortion in welds, and in that process we are going to have the discussion about the different other types of distortion. That is, one is bowing, or that is also known as longitudinal bending. Then apart from that, you have buckling as well as twisting, which is observed in the welds. So, in this lecture we are going to have some discussion over those phenomena. So, coming to bowing, or it is also known as longitudinal bending. So, this is basically when the weld line does not coincide with neutral axis of a weld structure. So, longitudinal shrinkage of the weld metal induces bending moments. So, in that case you will have the longitudinal stress which is there, so that will be inducing the bending moment, and that results into the longitudinal distortion of the structure. And that is also known, as cambering or bowing. So, in that case, you know, the amount of distortion basically that will be depending upon the resistance of the member to bending. So, how much resistance it is offering. So, based on that, it will be your amount of distortion will be depending upon. And as we know that there are certain you know, properties of the material or structure also that you know tells about what will be the resistance to bending. So, in those cases, those you know properties are you know taken into account while calculating these you know bowing or bending. So, basically you can understand basically what happens, that your structure you know becomes you know like this. So, that way you know your any section is there. So, so this section you know can be you can have a section, and then that will be. So, for this section, suppose you have I section. So, you will have this as the neutral axis. And this basically will be termed as the you know span length, and you know so what happens that this is the amount, this basically amount is known as the you know longitudinal distortion. So, that is in terms of mm. So, this is your neutral axis which is passing, and the longitudinal bending can be calculated using you know a formula. So, that amount is being calculated as 0.005 a d l square upon I. So, that is your longitudinal bending which is being calculated. So, here you have all these terminologies, that is A is the cross sectional area of the weld. Similarly, you have D as the distance from CG to, so distance from center of gravity, that is CG, to outermost fiber. So, that is in terms of mm. Then you have other you know standard terminologies, that is your L, that is your length of weld, and I, as we know, that is a moment of inertia of section. So, this will be in terms of mm4, this will be in terms of mm. Similarly, all these you know D will be also in mm, area of cross section of the weld will be in mm square. So, that way you can have the calculation of the longitudinal bending you know in the different kind of you know the welded structure. So, suppose you have the different cases and you want to calculate the longitudinal bending in all the cases. So, suppose you have you know one section where your you know welding is you know for this section. So, you have two sections which is welded, and in this case, so for these two sections the dimension is you know given as this is, this dimension is given as 75, And similarly, this dimension also is you know, given as 75. Then this is your 5 mm, and you know, in that case, and if you talk about you know, so this is your axis. So now this length becomes 30. Now if you talk about this angle sections, if you are taking first section is the angle section. Now for this angle section, if you want to, you know, find these longitudinal bending. So you know, what we see is that you have the leg length of the weld, so leg length of the weld is shown to be 5 mm. So this L is given as you know, 5 mm here in this case. Now you have to calculate, you know, in these cases. So your D is you know, calculated, and D is shown to be, you know, plus you know, 21.34 mm, and your I mean, that is 177.311315 mm raised to the power 4. So you have to calculate, you know, the moment of inertia of the structure, and based on that you can have the, so once you know the neutral axis though, so you can measure the value of D, and we know the L. So you know, so how you calculate that? So suppose you have you know, in this case you have you assume that there is a triangular weld. So assuming, you know, a triangular weld, so in this case, as you know that we calculate the area of the weld. So area of the weld will be, you know, half into weld length. So that will be 5 and 5 both side. So it will be 5 and 5. So it will be 12.5 mm square. Now, you know, so you have the distance of the neutral axis and of the section and neutral axis of the weld. So that D, that will be, you know, indicated as the plus value, and that plus value indicates that distance D is above the neutral axis of the sixth section. So basically this you know, distance between neutral axis of section and neutral axis of weld, so that is being calculated as the plus value of 21.34 mm. As we indicated that the plus value indicates that the neutral axis of the you know, section, it is above the, so that you know, weld, that is above the neutral axis of the section. So that's why this value is you know, 21.34. Your I, that is you know, section, that is given as 177 and 315, that is mm4. Now length of the section, if you look at this length of the section is you know, 3635 mm. So so because that is given, that if you your section which is you know, given, this section's length is given as 635 mm. So this is again one the input value. So once you know all these values, in that case you know, so the thing is that once you have these you know, sections, for that you have to find the neutral axis, you have to find the moment of inertia, you have to must know the neutral axis of the weld. So accordingly that D will be calculated, and all that you know, once calculated, then you will be finding these you know, longitudinal bending values. So that value, as we know that you have the formula 0.05, so 0.05 into you have A D into L square. So A we have calculated, that is 12.5, D is calculated as 21.34, And then you have L is 635 square, and divided by you have in the bottom you have I, that is 177315. So if you try to calculate longitudinal bending of this section, triangular section, so that comes out to be something like 3.03 mm. So this is the way of calculation for a for the longitudinal bending in case of triangular or angle section, not triangular, it's there in the angle section. This is for the angle section. Next, if suppose you have another case where you have the strip is welded to thick plate. Suppose, so the situation can be represented by you have a strip, and this strip is welded to a thick plate. So in this case this is the weld which is here. So in this case the the deflection, so that is your, so this dimension, that is L is given as 915. Now in this case what we calculate, you have the in this case your leg length, so L is taken as 7 mm, and this is your axis, so this length is 20 mm. So this is 20 mm, and this dimension is 50 mm. Now this is your neutral axis, and this length is also given as 50. Here it is 6, and here, so how you now calculate the longitudinal bending value for such cases? So in this case we have to calculate the deflection. Now what we see in this case is that your L is given as 7 mm, that is given, that is leg length is given as 7 mm. Now again, weld section, if you take at as the triangular one, so area of the area of two fillets, so you have two fillet weld here, so if you take it as the triangular one, so it will be 2 into 1 by 2 into 7 into 7. So your 7 is here, and 7 is like this. So ultimately it becomes 49 mm square. Now the D basically which is calculated to be plus 7.34 mm. So that is the distance between the neutral axis of the section and neutral axis of the weld, and neutral axis of the weld basically being positive value indicates that your neutral axis of the weld is above the neutral axis of the section. So accordingly your this value is D 7.34 mm. If you calculate the moment of inertia of the section, so that is computed out to be 513213 mm square. So this is your moment of inertia of the section, and then L comes out to be 915 mm. So for this for such strip welded to the thick sheet, thick base, now you can again find the the value of the longitudinal bending, and that again you will be coming out as you will put it like 0.005 into area, that is 49. Similarly, you will have the after area term, you have the D term. D is coming as 7.34, and then you have the term, that is your L square. So L is your 915 square, and then 513213. So that comes out to be 2.93 mm. So this way, in this case, your deflection, that is deflection which you calculate, that is coming out calculated deflection, that is coming out to be 2.93 mm. So that way, you may have the different cases. Suppose there are some cases like you have the I section with a plate which is welded to the top flange. So in those cases, if suppose you have in this case you have one I section is there, and so you will have there is one I section, and then in this, so this is also same dimension, and here you have a plate which is welded. So for the I section with a plate welded to this top flange, we are welding this plate, and this plate has suppose 5 into 100, that is your plate dimension, and this if you look at the distances, so you will have the neutral axis, and this distance is computed out again to be 91.45. So this is your I beam, and your in this case your L becomes 5 mm, and D is computed out to be 94.59 mm. So that is, and then you have I. So I is computed out to be 3360 2363, so mm raised to the power 4. So in that case, basically your this L dimension which is calculated, this is 14 then 55 mm. So again, you can have the values, and you can calculate the delta value. So if you find the longitudinal bending values, in that case it comes out again, you are putting, so it will be coming as 0.745 mm. So accordingly, in this fashion you can find the values of the longitudinal bending for all the cases. In all the cases you have to find these moment of inertia, you have to find the neutral axis, you have to find the neutral axis of the weld, finding the difference between these values, and then accordingly you can have the value of the delta LB calculation for the different cases. So that's how you can have the calculation of such values. Now coming to the another case of the distortion, that is your rotational distortion. Now the rotational distortion, that is observed ahead of the point of welding, and in this case the sheets being butt welded, either they come close to each other or the distance between them is widened. So many a times what happens that you are you have the two sheets which you are trying to weld. Now these sheets, either they try to come close to each other, or they are trying to separate. So when you are doing the welding, so depending upon many parameters, especially you may go for slow welding or you may go for fast welding. So when you go for the fast welding, or so in that case normally what happens that it tries to separate out, so the distance between their ends which is free at that at this moment, so that becomes more. And when you normally go for the slow welding, so it is likely that when you are moving towards the end, these the distance between the two ends, which should be which should be separate, at one point, so basically that it comes down, so they overlap each other. So that kind of thing is seen. So that can be understood by referring to these figures, where we see that this is the case of the slow weld. So when you have the slow welding going on, in that case their distance is basically reduced, whereas when you go for the fast welding, in that case their distance between them basically increases. So basically what is happening in this case, as you see here, so for a given thickness of the material, and when we see that there will be large temperature difference between the molten weld pool and the unheated parent material on these two sides, so basically there is a limit at which the heat can be extracted out. So heat can be conducted away in the vicinity of this weld pool. So that limit basically if the heat input is basically more than the limit, then the isothermal lines will take another form. So basically this difference in that heat flow depending upon for any particular case for a given thickness of the material, so that limit has to be maintained, and if you that exceeds in that case, there may be these problems. So these are the two cases in this case, and what you see that you have in one case it is coming closer, and another case it is going away from them, and that's what can be understood by knowing that expansion and expanding and the contracting zones in these figures. So you have the slow weld here and you have the fast weld here. So what you see that this is your in this case you can look at, so this is C, this is your slow weld, and this is your expansion and this is your contraction, and this similarly this is your fast weld, and in this case this zone, as you see, this expanded zone is expanded up to this place, whereas in this case you are going fast, so this region is basically cooled down, whereas very nearly near this place what you see, this is your expanded zone. So so in this case, so basically because of these they are giving one restraint to the either retaining its position or so. So so in one case they will be prevented by returning to their original position or mean position, and in that case basically their distortion results into. So this is a case of the slow and fast welds in the case of and that results into these rotational distortion in such cases. So you have regions X and region Y which is shown. So you have the contracting zones, you have the expanding zones. So based on that you can understand that how these result into the either the moving closer to each other or moving away from each other. So accordingly that can be justified. Next kind of distortion, which is also observed, that is your buckling. So buckling as well as twisting. Now in the case of buckling, so while welding thin plates we see that considerable residual stresses occur in areas away from the weld that will cause the buckling. So this type of distortion will occur when the specimen length exceeds the critical length for a given thickness. So what happens that you have some critical length for a given thickness, so that one there are values given for that, and based on that you can have. So what happens in such cases, you know, when we talk about the buckling, so you have you know, the calculation of the critical thickness. So you will have this the suppose critical thickness is there, so that is you know, in mm, and this side you will have the breadth of plate. So you know, the ratio goes like this. So what happens, you know, this way it goes. So this is your aspect ratio, and aspect ratio b by l, that will be 0. Similarly, this will be b by l is 0.5, and this will be b by l, that will be for 1. So suppose critical thickness values can be, you know, found from here, and you know, from from this point, suppose if your suppose b by l, so if suppose b is 2 meter and for l is say length of the plate is 1 meter, and your b is so b by l, you know, that becomes 1. So now in that case, you know, by looking at this point, if you look at the breadth of the plate, suppose you are taking breadth as so breadth will be here, suppose 0.5, then you have you know, 1, then 1.5, then you have 2. So this is in terms of meter, and this is your critical thickness. So for a particular breadth, you go there and you look at the b by l value, and based on this b by l value, your critical thickness, so it will be suppose say 2, 4, 6, 8, like that, it will move. So based on that, you can have the value of the critical thickness. So the plate will be going to buckle if the thickness is less than that value. So depending upon this value, suppose you are coming here, so it will be something like more than 4. So if the thickness is less than this, you know, this value, suppose if you take suppose 1.5 or so. So in that case, wherever it falls, if the thickness is less than that, then the material is going to buckle. So that way, you know, this buckling is defined. Now, you know, first of all, what we also have seen that in the case of you know, buckling, the amount of deformation is much more than that is found in the case of you know, bending, because you know, there is you know, more than one you know, the stable shape in the case of buckling. So one stable, more than one stable deformed shape is there in the buckling, and then you have the you know, amount of deformation which is there in buckling, which is quite larger than that in the case of you know, bending. Then you know, we have the case of twisting. Now twisting is basically observed in the case of problem when you have the thin material and it has the low torsional resistance. So in that case, it gets twisted, and twisting can be prevented or minimized by minimizing the shrinkage force by good welding practice, keeping length of welded member short, and incorporating much resistance to the twisting. So that way, if you you know, you increase the thickness, or if you have increased rigidity or so, in those cases the twisting can also be, you know, avoided or prevented. So these are the, you know, normal kinds of distortion which we come across in the welds, and because of that basically they are you know, out of the shape. So we will have in our next lecture talking about the you know, methods to you know, prevent or minimize the distortion in the welds. Thank you very much.